If we think about somebody, we want to call them on the telephone, and then we call them. Quite often, people feel our intention before we make the call. They start thinking about us, and when we make the call, they say, "That's funny, I was just thinking about you." Now, I've done a lot of experiments that show the sense of being stared at is real. The telephone telepathy is not just a coincidence, it's not just random chance. It's a real phenomenon. If our minds are extended beyond our brains and interconnect us with the world around us and with each other, it means that we're much more interconnected than we usually assume. The materialist theory, still the dominant orthodoxy, says that the mind is inside the brain. That means each of us is isolated from each other in the privacy of our skulls. It means we're much more private, but we're much more isolated. Now, this view of our thoughts and intentions interconnecting us with the world around us, with animals, with other people, means that we're much more interconnected. In a sense, we're less private because our thoughts and intentions can affect other people. Their thoughts and intentions can affect us. But I think that's the way things are. We're social animals and we've evolved to live in groups with other people. And no social animals can survive unless they're interconnected with other members of their group. We see this in every social animal. Ants, bees, wasps, termites, in flocks of birds, in schools of fish, in packs of wolves. All social animals have coordination with other members of the group, and I think that telepathy is a normal means of communication among social animals between members of groups. So that's one implication. We're much more interconnected than we might otherwise be. Another implication is that our brains are not doing everything they're usually assumed to do. I think brains are grossly overrated at present, because people assume the brain is doing everything. I think the brain is more like a receiver, more like a TV receiver than like a video recorder. It's not storing everything and doing everything. It's open to transmissions that come from outside, and it's sending out transmissions to the world around it. So it's working in a completely different way. So I think this would lead to a very different understanding of ourselves and of our minds. It also would suggest that these so-called paranormal phenomena, like telepathy, are not paranormal at all. They're perfectly normal. They're part of our animal nature. Animals have them too. They've evolved because they're useful.